11 o'clock. Do you know where your users are clicking? I'm Olivia with Whole Whale, and I can tell you where your users are clicking, or you can tell yourself using an outbound link trigger in Google Tag Manager. Okay, but what's Google Tag Manager? If our house is using in-window units for air conditioning, that is our Google Analytics. We have an air conditioning unit in the living room, we have one in the bedroom, we have one in the dining room, we have one in the library, in the conservatory with the lead pipe. You get what I'm saying. Google Tag Manager, however, lets us install central air, and that is what we all want in life, right? And rather than having to go from room to room, turning on switches, turning off switches, we have one method to rule it all, especially when it comes to getting more granular with the actions we want users to be taking on site. One of those actions can be clicking on an outbound link. Now, why would we want to track an outbound link click? There are a number of reasons. If you are running two or more websites, it may not be that cross-domain tracking is the best way to get a sense of how users are interacting between sites. You may also not have Google Analytics for access for a certain site that you're sending users to, and so you can get a much stronger sense of how effective your referrals actually are. Let's look at how to set that up.
Okay, so once you are logged into your Google Tag Manager account and you're in the right workspace, you're going to hit on Tags, and then you're going to click New. You're going to want to name your tag in line with what you want to track, so we'll call this one Outbound Link Clicks. And then in tag configuration, we have a ton of options for tag type. Google makes this very easy. We can go with the first option there, Universal Analytics, which is what we're going to go with for most basic tag configurations rather than scrolling through everything else. First thought, best thought. Under track type, we're going to click event since this is how we'll be tracking this in Google Analytics. And then under category, we're going to type in outbound links. In action, we will type in click. And then in label, we're going to type in the two open brackets or fancy open parentheses and find click URL and click that so that it populates within GTM. And then under non-interaction hitbox, usually in Google Analytics, since bounce rate is calculated by the number of single page sessions divided by all sessions for each page, we want to make this false so that we can tell Google Analytics, hey, this is an interaction. But since this is going to an outbound link click, we most likely want to keep this as true. We don't want this to affect bounce rate. If we were tracking this from one site to another and both sites are owned by the same organization, it may make more sense to list this as false, but let's just go ahead and save that and choose our trigger. Now we already have one in place for outbound link clicks, but if we were configuring from scratch, here's how it would look. Under trigger type, we would go for click and go for just links. And then that will automatically give us some options where we're going to want to wait for tags. We'll set the max wait time as the default 2000 milliseconds, which means that the trigger will wait for up to 2 seconds for all of the tags that use this trigger to be ready before taking the user to the link. We also want to check validation so we can make sure that the link is valid. That's always a good thing to have. And then we want to enable when the URL matches regular expression, period asterisk. This means that the trigger is enabled on all pages linked to from our website. If we wanted to break down the outbound link clicks, we could also play with customization in this area. So for instance, we have this trigger configured to fire on all URLs that do not match the Whole Whale site, meaning that we're taking people off page. And we want to make sure that we're sending people to a www, a .org, .com, or .edu. We'll hit save for the trigger, hit save for the tag, and then we want to make sure that we are keeping everything kosher by going into preview mode and check to see if anything needs to be debugged. So I'm going to go into preview mode, and then I'm going to open Whole Whale's website in a new tab. And once we open it up, it's very easy to tell when you're in preview mode. Google Tag Manager will pop up in the bottom of the screen and we'll see what tags are firing on the page and what tags aren't. So I'm seeing here the outbound link clicks. I'm going to scroll down on the page for Whole Whale until I find an external link. And let's go with our LinkedIn page. I'm going to open that up in a new window and then check back on my old window. And sure enough, I see that we have outbound link clicks tracking, which means that this tag is working. So from there, back into Google Tag Manager and push to go live.
Okay, but what do we do with all of these data? We can look at the most popular links and most popular pages that we're sending people to offsite. If you have, say, one page with a number of links, this may be a good idea of how to prune that down and just focus on the ones that are getting activity. And if you have a click that you want people to be taking on your site and they're not taking it, that is a perfect opportunity to do a little bit of A/B testing. Google or any other search engine crawls a website through links, both internal links and outbound links. So getting a sense of how effective your link strategy is only going to give you a better sense of how your site is optimized for search engines. I'm Olivia with Whole Whale, and speaking of search engine optimization, we have a whole course for that. You can learn all about the technical foundations of SEO, as well as writing content that captures, engages, and converts. Find that course at wholewhale.com/university. You can even access it at a discount with the code WWVideo. Thanks a lot, and see you soon.